Hello and welcome to Hacking the Excel, the show which lets you see all of the behind information that you need to really appreciate the Excel 6E webisode series. In this day, we suffer lack of show host, and so I will try to replace our normal show host, Mr. Matthias Bjarnemalm, and guide you through the latest webisode series. In the last few weeks, we have engaged on journeys for Germany to visit the German Pirate Party on their National Congress. We're all very excited to see how they will set their lists in January for the European elections. And of course, Excel 6E will also be present at the Bochum Conference in Nordrhein-Westphalia on the 4th and 5th of January in 2014. In this week's webisode, you will see our experiences from Bremen, where we visited a 1,200-person congress where the German pirates, among other things, accepted a common European election program for the elections in 2014. The many adventures that we experienced, you will find in that place, and I can assure you, German annual congresses are always great places for friends, joy, and political scheming for the future. Brussels is of course filled with different events and organizations that try to raise important political issues on the topic. Therefore, in the last week's webisode, we could see my participation in a security and defense agenda event on the lack of IT security professionals and how we politically can address this lack. One of the issues which I had been hoping to bring up during that event, but which unfortunately was lost to me in the course of the proceedings, was that it's of high concern that NATO officials and generals will come to public events and say that they have cozy, informal exchanges with companies and security professionals that allow them to build a kind of closed networks of the trusted to talk about insecurities that everybody else suffers from. While it's of course always convenient for people to have friends in the security world, it's not good when social networks around IT security are formed around the military, because often we do not associate the military the most with an effective market economy. And we're currently running, it seems to me, a risk of outsourcing much of the financial planning and economical security to intelligence agencies and companies, to intelligence agencies and military apparatuses. This is a political challenge which should be addressed on a market-based term and with a more liberal view to how we as a society can effectively exchange information and communication with each other. But of course, such a political change will maybe take some more deliberation, and particularly we will need better political support, including from enterprises. The European Union is one of the most unique institutions in the world, which is always, with a liberal framing, tried to create interdependencies between the European countries so that they may exchange trade, social interactions, friendships, products and services without being enemies with each other. This liberal idea is now in a desperate need for a renaissance. That is why, for the European elections, I would like to launch a European net peace agenda which can involve European businesses, entrepreneurs, innovators and citizens to reconquer the internet as the socializing and economically beneficial platform that we've been told it is. A European net peace agenda easily ties back into the old ideas of the European Union and the founding fathers like Robert Schuman and other intellectuals from the 1950s and 60s who believed that actually it is possible also for Europeans to get along, despite history showing us for a long time that Europe doesn't really. But what we need is for both companies and citizens in Europe to understand that it's always better to trust and cooperate than not to trust and not cooperate, and that there is a very big potential for the European Union to use the internet in a way which is highly conducive to the European idea. This will also require some amount of political leadership from both the member states and from the European Commission. It's currently looking unlikely that we will be able to overcome the very tight bonds that exist between law enforcement apparatuses and intelligence agency apparatuses and the highest political levels of government. So this will be our last Hacking the Excel webisode series. In the next year, we will be continuing making the Excel 6E webisodes as normal, starting out with our experiences from Germany and eventually finalizing at the very beginning of the election campaign. We would like to thank you for your attention and for staying with us as we present all of the cast members that make the Excel 6E office able to function and operate in Brussels at high efficiency. We want to thank the audience and also the film crew for providing continued assistance with our production of this series, and we hope that you've enjoyed it and that you will remain watching the Exile 6E webisode series and following the information and communication policies of the European Union and the European Parliament also in the future. Thank you very much.